Welcome to another episode of Dr. Welling's Health Show. Today we are going to discuss foods for hypothyroid. When you are super tired all day and every day losing weight is a big issue, your hair is not shiny anymore and you feel lethargic and constipated, it is likely your thyroid gland are underactive. The biggest problem of hypothyroid is that most of the women are unaware that they are suffering from this. An undiagnosed case may even lead to risk of other serious illnesses such as heart disease, osteoporosis, and even infertility. According to recent study, 1 out of 8 women will develop a thyroid disorder in her lifetime. The known cases are often difficult to manage and your diet can be a big influential factor in it. Today I am going to tell you 4 varieties of foods which you need to prevent in diet to manage your hypothyroid better. Number 1 is dairy. Dairy products such as cheese, ice cream, yogurt and cow's milk are better avoided. It proposes a lot of inflammation in the body. The casein protein present in the dairy products often worsens autoimmune diseases. You can watch my other videos on milk and alternative for milk products. Soya proteins. Soya proteins are long been thought of as a negative marker for hypothyroid. One study suggests that it may increase a person's risk for hypothyroidism by more than 40%. It can also affect the absorption of thyroid medication that you might be on. In today's modern agriculture, genetically modified soya beans are also a source of something called as goitrogens. These are the substances which inhibit iodine absorption in your body. Refined sugar. Sugar is always bad for you in excess and for your thyroid gland especially. It has adverse effect on your immune system and pushes you towards autoimmune diseases. It is advisable to reduce the amount of refined sugar to the least possible. And number 4, the cabbage family, that is raw cruciferous vegetables. Otherwise full of fibers, cruciferous vegetables such as cabbage, broccoli, cauliflower, Brussels sprouts contain substances like goitrogens which affect iodine absorption. A deficiency in iodine further leads to abnormal thyroid functioning. Hence, when you are diagnosed with thyroid abnormality, it's better to stay away from cabbage family till your thyroid levels are not normalized. That's all in today's episode. See you in the next episode. Don't forget to share this video to help your friends overcome thyroid issues. If you have any health question, feel free to ask in the comment section below. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel to get the updates as soon as I release a new video. Helping you get back to your health and stay healthy. Bye and take care.